Hey guys, this is Robbie Frank, and in this video, we're going to talk about the secret ingredient behind achieving your goals. This ingredient is what usually ends up determining whether you actually accomplish your goals or not, and I'm going to break it down quickly for you. So whenever you set out to achieve a goal, there's basically the starting point, which is where you currently find yourself when you're starting. And of course, there's also the end point, which is where you want to be. And any worthwhile goal is a process. So it takes time to go from here to here. It could take a day, a week, a month, a year, a decade, and it could be in any field that's important for you. But the point is, goals are about you being at a starting point and taking some path to reach an ending point. Now, what people usually are not aware of is what I like to call the unknown zone. So every goal at some point, whether it's the relative start of it, the middle, the end of it, you get to a point where you're in unknown territory. So let's say that so far since you began, you had the known territory, which is however hard you thought you had to work, the skills you currently have, the just mental power you have to barrel through challenges. And then there's the unknown area. Now, again, any goal that's worthwhile, any goal that you actually have to work for will have that zone where you reach the unexpected. So something challenging happened. Maybe the goal ends up taking more time than you thought. Maybe you need skills that you didn't know you need. And what usually happens is at this point, the beginning, what you see is mostly enthusiasm. You see a lot of passion. So you see passion, you see comfort, you see happiness, excitement, basically a lot of really positive emotions that are related to the beginning of achieving your goal. And this these awesome feelings, they will pass. And they will be replaced eventually by the unknown zone, where what you have is mostly discomfort, a lack of enthusiasm. So you could call it maybe challenge. You could call it also suffering. So often suffering is also involved. And pain and doubt and uncertainty. Basically everything that you don't like in life. So again, this graph, it represents any goal that's worthwhile. So you'll never have a goal where the result is actually worth it that does not include this chasm, this change from, okay, so far it was good, and suddenly it's not good. And the higher you aim, the quicker and longer you'll reach the unknown zone. So if you set out to achieve a goal that's fairly easy, you might encounter it at the end, or you might even not encounter it at all. But any goal that's even slightly hard will have that part that's the unknown zone. And that's really the zone where you develop as a person. So you could also call this, by the same token, you could also call this the growth zone, because this is the part where you have to learn new skills. You have to become mentally tougher. And the thing is, when most people reach that zone, when most people start seeing that gradual change from, okay, so far it was comfortable, suddenly here it's like not as comfortable, what happens is they just give up and they say, okay, this area, this whole thing, it's clearly not for me. It's too hard, too painful, not fun. Let's instead go over here. And they set out to achieve a new goal, maybe in a different area, maybe a different time. And they think, okay, maybe this one, I'm going to be able to pull myself all the way through without actually experiencing the discomfort zone. And what happens is, sure enough, they start out up to this point. There is excitement, there is fun, there's growth, passion, again, all of these. And suddenly, they hit another wall here, and the negative emotions start showing up. And what they do is they say, okay, this is also not for me. So I'm going to go here. And again, changing directions, going for a completely new thing, hoping this time it will be different. And eventually you've gone through so many of these paths and failed that you just start boxing yourself in. So you say, okay, so here I clearly can't go. This is not a good direction. This is not a good direction either. And you basically left yourself with nowhere to go. So the only things that you can do at this point is either aim so low that like you won't even get to experience discomfort, in which case you just won't grow, or you'll just basically cease aiming in general, just thinking that, okay, goals are, you know, something that just, it's not for me, you know, I should just flow with life, you know, go with what feels right, which means you basically gave up on the idea of growth, and you'll only be lucky if bad things happen, because that's the only chance in life that you'll have to grow. So how do you actually contend with this thing? Let's go back to before you gave up. How do you actually contend with this? So basically what you have to do is to get to this part and survive it. There are a couple of things you can do. So let's call it solutions. So the first thing you can do is to find something that you love. So first solution is just love what you do. So when you love what you do, when you really, really love that area, that field, there's a higher than regular chance that you'll actually go through all the way. You know, if you actually love this area of your life, you're more likely to stay the course. The other thing you can do is to initially decide to lower your expectations. So pessimistic from the start. So just based on like the Grant Cardone's 10X rule, just assume it's going to take 10 times more effort than you initially thought. And then what happens is when you reach this zone, you're like, okay, I expected this and I'm not concerned. Because again, the problem is that people think that this zone starts here when in actuality it usually starts around here relative to actually completing your goal. And the third solution, which is you could say the most generally good for your life, is to build mental toughness. Now, what is mental toughness? Mental toughness is basically what I like to call the ability to pursue something despite pain, suffering, doubt, negativity, etc. So the ability to stay the course, that is what mental toughness is. And people that are mentally tough, people like Navy SEALs, like hardcore business people, like athletes, these are people that we admire because of their ability to stay in this discomfort zone and push on. Now, how do you actually go about developing this mental toughness? What is the best way to develop it? So in my experience, the single best way for you to develop mental toughness is through sports. It's through physical challenges. Why? Now, why is that? The reason is in most things that you do in life, so whatever area you decide to pursue in life, it's usually very, very complicated. There's usually multiple variables that you have to account for. So let's say that what you're currently pursuing is something related to business. Now, in your business venture, even if you're just doing sales, what do you have to account for? You have to account for the actual script and the actual amount of calls. And you have to also account for refunds. And you also have to account for persuasion and charisma and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. There's basically an almost infinite amount of things that you can focus on at the end of the day that many of them are out of your control. Now, on the other hand, let's say that you're dealing with athletics and that you simply choose an athletic field to pursue, so sports. Now, what sort of things do you have to account for here? It's your body, it's your health, it's your breathing, it's your movement, it's your attitude. And these are all things that are completely in your control. And also the finish line is much clearer, because in business, you might make money and end up losing it all. You might have refunds, there may be problems with your payment processing. So there's always things that might get in your way. But in sports, all you really have to do is just put on running shoes and just get to work. And literally it could be as simple as doing 300 pull-ups in an hour, meaning like 5 pull-ups every minute, or it could be even more challenging, like doing a 3-hour run or any other thing that you can think of to pursue physically. Now, when you pursue these physical things, what's going to happen is you're going to reach the discomfort point, the unknown part, fairly quickly, and you're going to be forced to stay in there. So again, it's a lot more complicated with something like sales or business, because some things you do are comfortable, some things are uncomfortable, sometimes you have to mix the two. But when you do sports, you know when you're in this discomfort zone, it's very clear what you have to do, and you can directly work on your mental toughness. So by building this muscle of mental toughness, in addition to the mental tools I've shown you here, you'll be able to pursue and basically withstand the unknown, the discomfort, the challenge, the suffering, the pain, the doubt, the uncertainty. And the more mental toughness you develop, the more success you'll have in every area of your life in general. And the reason is simple. The reason is, again, in every area of your life, you will hit that discomfort zone anytime that you pursue something meaningful. So to summarize, anytime you set a goal, there's the known part and then there's the unknown part. Whenever the goal is anything that's even remotely respectable, there will be a part that includes these negative things. So the harder the goal, the more likely you are to spend time in the discomfort zone experiencing these things. How do you solve this? Again, by loving what you do, there's a higher chance that you'll withstand this area. By being pessimistic from the start, you won't be surprised when you hit it, because you won't think it's here. You'll know already that it's probably here. And by building mental toughness, you'll be able to withstand this area in all around in every area of your life. Hope this video helps you. Let me know if you have any questions. Feel free to like, share, and subscribe. See you soon.